Welcome to Northfield's first If Music Be the Food benefit concert. My name is Joanne Rodland and I'm the artistic director of If Music Be the Food Northfield. Due to the coronavirus pandemic, this initial concert must be virtual, but we look forward to seeing you in person at our next one. First United Church of Christ is our host, and these concerts will benefit Northfield's Community Action Center. Since moving to Northfield some 6 years ago, I have realized what I suspected all along. The arts are central to the life of this community, and the desire to reach out and help others energizes its pulse. Clearly, it is fertile ground for a series such as If Music Be the Food. Founded in 2009 in Rochester, New York, it is a series of benefit concerts which raise awareness and support through the sharing of great music for our neighbors in the local community who are experiencing food insecurity. To learn more about If Music Be the Food and to see postings about future concerts, please visit www.ifmusicbethefood.com. We are so very grateful to First United Church of Christ Northfield for welcoming us here for this event, and we look forward to future collaboration with this congregation, which is so committed to outreach. Chris Brunel, Director of Music, will share a few words with you. Chris?
Hello and welcome. I'm Chris Brunel, and I'm the Director of Music here at First United Church of Christ in Northfield. And I'm delighted that we're able to host today's concert, though of course I wish we could do it with you here in the church as well. I'm delighted that we can do it under the auspices of If Music Be the Food of Love and in support of Northfield's own Community Action Center. We all know that we have the feeling that we're part of something larger than ourselves. And we all have the feeling that we need to be part of something larger than ourselves. Here at First UCC, we've been part of something larger than just the church through many concerts like this with community organizations and in support of other groups in the area and throughout the nation, not just Community Action Center, but many others as well. And I'm grateful for music because it helps us understand that feeling of being part of something larger than ourselves. Whether we are musicians ourselves or whether we're listening to music, we can feel that it's not just us and that we're not just alone, even if we're in isolation, but that there is a larger group of which we are a part and of which we are meant to be a part. So in that spirit, I hope that you enjoy today's concert, and I hope that we can meet together again soon in person here at First UCC. Thank you.
Thank you, Chris. And we are delighted to be able to collaborate with the Northfield Community Action Center in our efforts to reach out to those in need. Their work will be highlighted by the CA's director, Scott Lopata. The link for your donations to this worthy work, https://communityactioncenter.org/donate/. In this unusual time of the coronavirus, the Rodland Carson family has been all together in one place here in Northfield. The Rodland duo, daughters Catherine and Carol, and the Carson duo, grandchildren John and Kate, along with Jamie Bob, St. Olaf professor, colleague, and friend, are your performers for this opening concert. With their gifts of music, the artists in the If Music Be the Food collaborations complete the picture as they nurture our souls, even as we seek to nurture others through our gifts to feed their bodies. In the words of If Music Be the Food's founder, Carol Rodland, music, food, love. It is all here in what we are doing together with each If Music Be the Food concert. Thank you and enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you. incredibly hard to ask for help. So everything that we do, we want to make things as comfortable and feel as safe as possible. The over 4,000 people that we serve every year, many of them come to us first for food, but in talking with people and building relationship and trust, we quickly learn that that's not the only need. And so that's a really good opportunity. Food is a great way to build a relationship, and that's a good opportunity to figure out how else we might be able to help. We've made a lot of changes at Community Action Center over the last 2 years, starting with a full redesign of our food shelf. We did a ton of work to create a food shelf that feels very dignified and respectful. It also placed a huge focus on healthy, fresh produce. We have overall, over the last year, seen an over 30% increase in the number of people accessing the food shelf. That was prior to the COVID-19 pandemic. Unfortunately, with a pandemic, you can't always do the things that you want to do. And so we've had to move to actually an outdoor drive-through model for our food shelf. We have a limited amount of volunteers and staff in our food shelf at a time, and they're packing food for families and bringing it directly out to cars. So that's been hard because it's not the way that we want to do it, but we are very focused on remaining open and serving the community with food and other basic needs and resources at a time where people need them the most. On any given day, we typically serve about 20 to 25 households. And we've seen anywhere from 36 to 56 households served per day. So that's a really significant increase in people accessing food. And it's a lot of people that we have never met before. Right now, we're seeing this immense food need coming at us. But I think over time, those needs are going to change. As news across the country changes every single day, so does our response. I feel like that's the next wave of keeping people stabilized in their homes and preventing eviction and stabilizing families in other ways beyond food. I think that hopefully our services and the work we do will be more visible in the community. More people will know where to get help. I'm hopeful that that will also send the message that we're here for people. And we're ready to serve and we're ready to help, even for people who would never imagine that they would have needed help before.